My name is Leville Clocker, and I'm a Senior Principal Architect at Red Hat. Service providers are looking for better ways to operate and manage their new and highly distributed networks. This is especially true with Cloud RAN and Edge deployments, where they need to manage systems in several thousand locations, from dense urban cities to remote rural areas. Manual operations or sending out skilled technicians is no longer a viable option at this kind of scale. The solution is clearly automation, and in particular, a GitOps and zero-touch provisioning approach for day one and day two operations, resulting in lower operational costs and higher reliability in rolling out updates. This video is a demonstration of how a leading service provider in the telecom industry is planning to implement Red Hat's GitOps and ZTP solution to operate their Cloud RAN network that will consist of tens of thousands of sites. In particular, it showcases the ZTP-based deployment and the ongoing lifecycle management activities like upgrading the software on remote OpenShift clusters, using GitOps and advanced cluster management to simplify this process at scale. By leveraging these technologies, service providers can upgrade a test site, validate the site, and then roll out these upgrades across the entire network in an instance, resulting in immense time and cost savings. Over to you, Jonas. Take us through the demo.
Hello, my name is Jonas Arndt. I'm a senior architect for consulting, telco. I'm going to show a demo here on how to do upgrades using policy gen templates. The first thing we're going to do here is look at the existing policies. Snow 1 and Snow 2, those are the guys we're going to upgrade, and we can see that they're all compliant, right? And we're going to take a look at the common side under site policies, and we look at the upgrade YAML here, and we can see that we are applying that to anything that is labeled 22B, and we have 4.12.15 that we're going to apply. They are on 4.12.4 today. Cool. So if we look at the customization YAML, we can see that 22B is not yet included. So we're going to uncomment that. So that thing is part of the policy gen templates and considered. And once we've done that, we can commit and push that up to Git. And then we quickly just do a sync. You don't have to do it, but it's going to take maybe 10 minutes before it syncs automatically. So that policy part of Argo is now synced, and we can go back and look at the policies again. And here we can see there are some new policies introduced. They are not marked as non-compliant because we don't have any snows or any spoke clusters yet with that has the 22B label. So let's go and make sure that we get those labels. If you look at ACM right now, you can see that the logical group is still set to 22A on Snow 1 and Snow 2. So we need to change that to 22B, and we do that by editing their site config files, and we change the logical group from 22A to 22B. Done. And we do the same thing for Snow 2. And we commit it, push it, and then after it's synced, we can now look at the policies, and we can see that now we have some violation. We have violation for Snow 2, and we have violation or non-compliant for Snow 1. So how do we change that now so that that actually gets enforced? We use Talon, and we use a cluster group upgrade CR for that. So let's take a look at that. It's a cluster group update CR, and we have these policies here that we're going to manage. And we have a couple of other things that we might want to take a look at. We see that the clusters are Snow 1 and Snow 2. We're setting backup to true, so we want to take a backup before we kick this off. We also have a canaries thing, which means that, we're going to try everything on the canary, which is just Snow 1. If that is successful, we're going to move on to the rest of the clusters. And we can see now that's just Snow 2, right? Okay, so let's apply the CGU then. And on the right-hand side here, you can see the clusters running, and they're 4.12.4. And this is node 2, it's also on 4.12.4. So now we create a CDU, and that thing is going to take care of the upgrade for us. Let's just take a look at what the CDU is actually doing right now. So it's in progress. It has started to do the upgrade. And it's actually, look at this, it's upgrading only on Snow 1 right now, because we have this canary set to Snow 1. Snow 2 is still waiting for the upgrade. Only if Snow 1 is successful, Snow 2 will be upgraded. And we can also look at some metrics here in Grafana and just look at the cluster versions. Let's see if we can push that down to just look at Snow 1. And if we look then at this from version thing, and then there is another property that's version. So we're going from 4.12.4 to 4.12.15. And it's still doing updating. Okay, so we did some time warping here, and we can see that Snow 1 is actually now completed, and therefore Snow 2 has started its upgrade. The same CDU is driving that. And we can see here then in Grafana that we are now done with the upgrade on Snow 1. And we have actually gone to 4.12.50. We still have a couple of violations here, and that's because Snow 2 is not done completely. All right, so now we are completely upgraded. And if we look at the policies here, or the CGU, we can see that it is completed. So that has fully gone by and upgraded those two clusters, and we have zero policy violation. And that actually concludes our demo.
Thank you very much for watching this demo. As you could see, GitOps and ZDP are very powerful tools to simplify the operation and lifecycle management of edge devices at scale. If you would like to learn more about the use of GitOps for your network, please contact us today. Thank you.